Well, hello there. It's been a long, long time. How am I doing? Well, I guess I'm doing fine. Well, it's been so long, but it seems like it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? How's your new love? I hope it's doing fine. I heard you told him you'd love him till the end of time. Now that's the same thing you told me. Seems like just the other day. Ain't it funny how time slips away? I guess I'll see you around. I don't know when I'll be back in town. But remember what I tell you, 'cause in time you're gonna pay. Ain't it funny how time slips away? Yeah, remember what I tell you, 'cause in time you're gonna pay. Surprising how time slips away. Slips away.
To induct WiLLIE NELSON into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Dave Matthews.
Nice.
This is one of those low microphones. Now I gotta look like I'm serious. Anyway, I get on with it. I only got a couple minutes, and I got a whole lot of shit to say. So just to get a perspective, WiLLIE NELSON wrote his first song in 1940. Come on! I mean, he was 7 years old, but that's pretty fucking impressive. Patsy Cline recorded the classic Crazy, released in 1961, and WiLLIE made 72 albums since his first, and he's an author. He just published a new book called Energy Follows Thought about his songs and writing them. He's been a movie star. He plays golf. I was standing with WiLLIE by WiLLIE at a concert celebrating his 85th birthday. He's 90 now. And some local TV station asked him when he was gonna retire. And he said, well, I play golf and I play music. Which one do you want me to give up? He also loves poker, and he recorded the Outlaws album with his poker buddy, Waylon Jennings. And it was the first, I'm trying to get it all in, so I'm shouting over you. It was the first country album ever to sell more than a million copies. Then he had another group with Waylon that was called the Highwaymen, and that also had a Johnny Cash and Kris Kristofferson in it, which is that's a wrecking crew. You don't want to get stuck in the bar with that band, Lord. Anyway, what else I got? Oh, you know what? Don't know if you know this. Willie likes to smoke weed. And according to several, or at least a couple of good sources, one time Willie smoked in the White House. And in his autobiography, he said it was with someone that worked there. But Jimmy Carter, who was president at the time, said that it was with Jimmy's son, which is, I like to think that if Jimmy Carter had been elected for a second term, that weed would have been legal in the mid-80s. And maybe we wouldn't have exported all of our manufacturing jobs if he had a second term. And maybe all the farmer subsidies and tax breaks that were afforded small family farms and small farmers in this country would not have been stolen by corporate and factory farm industries. But alas, so it goes. But farm foreclosures skyrocketed, and so did farmer suicide. And then Willie Nelson heard the voices of desperation, and he called John Mellencamp and Neil Young, and they did the first Farm Aid with a bunch of great artists in 1985. Willie has done Farm Aid every year since. Greed doesn't rest, so neither for now does Willie Nelson. The first time that I was at Farm Aid, we came off stage. That's the first time I met Willie. We came off stage and we went on his bus and after our set. And I got so high that I thought I might forget to breathe. And then we got more high, and then we continued to get high until finally Willie said, is everybody high? And my mom still has a photograph of me and the band so high on Willie's bus with Willie up on her. She's very proud of me. But there was it was around the same time that Willie had an issue with the IRS. He owed some back taxes. You should look on Wikipedia for how much, because I don't want to say it out loud because it's an embarrassingly large amount. Anyway, so he did a couple of Taco Bell commercials to pay the bill, and he did a Pizza Hut commercial with Waylon Jennings, and I figured that's okay, because then you're just taking the taxes from the corporation and you're giving them to the government, which is what we should be doing anyway. But then Bill Hicks, the late comedian, said, I miss him too. Said, you do a commercial and you're off the artistic roll call forever. And that goes for everyone, except Willie Nelson. Willie believes in doing right as he sees it. Everything just takes care of itself, he said. If everyone just takes care of themselves, then we don't have any problems. One time before Farm Aid, before the press conference, Willie and Neil, sorry if I'm nervous, this is really nervous, but I'm really nervous. So my apologies. One time before Farm Aid, not that, it was called maybe a decade and a half ago, me and Willie and Neil Young and John Mellencamp were on the side stage, and we were catching up a little bit. And while they were catching up, I was thinking, what the fuck am I doing here? And I don't know what we talked about, but Willie said, I didn't think I was going to write any more songs, but then I wrote a couple. And one of the ones he wrote was, Roll Me Up and Smoke Me When I Die. And then he recorded that with Snoop Dogg. And Snoop said that Willie was the only time he ever had to say, I can't smoke anymore. In conclusion, the world seems upside down, where people are living in the streets hoping that they will survive the winter in the richest country in the world, and where people working full-time for huge profitable corporations still have to get food stamps. And we have billionaires who, while competing for who can get their little rockets a tiny ways into space, or who has the biggest mega yacht, don't think they should pay taxes. While we rain bombs down on children and call it collateral damage or self-defense, it's enough for you to give up on the world. But it's people like Willie Nelson that made me hopeful for us all, through his words and through his music and through the example he sets. People feel a connection to Willie Nelson. Willie is an example of how the world could be if we could just straighten up and fly right.
You want to sing a song with my guitar, Willie?
First time that guitar's been played. I'm crazy. Wow. Crazy for feeling so lonely. Crazy for trying. Crazy for crying. And I'm crazy for loving you. Hello, Wall. How'd things go for you today?
I really got started as a writer in Nashville first with songs that other people recorded before I did as a singer.
And I'll bet you dread to spend.
I wanted to play. I wanted to get a band, go out on the road. And Aaron Young, he said, you stay here in Nashville and write for me and let me go out and do the tour.
Mr. Ray Price, the Cherokee Cowboy, recorded this one. When the evening.
I was playing bass for Ray Price, writing for his publishing company.
One week I wrote Funny How Time Slips Away, Crazy, and Nightlife. I thought they were good songs, but I had no idea what they would go on to become.
And the nightlife ain't no good life, but it's my life.
The Nashville sound back in those days, there was already an established way to do things, and I tried to do it their way for a while, but it wasn't the sound that I really wanted, which was the sound of me and the guitar.
He's a good-hearted woman in love with a good time.
I would play packed houses around the country, and yet I couldn't sell any records.
He loves him in spite of his ways that you don't understand.
So that's when I started thinking about moving back to Texas.
A shotgun, Willie sits around in his underwear. Fighting on a bullet and pulling out all of his.
My sister lived in Austin, so I went there to see her, and once I did, I said, well, this is where I gotta live.
When he moved to Texas and kind of abandoned any notion of what someone else thought he should be, that's when it really connected with people. For me, that's the foundation, and that move marked a very specific point in not just country music, but music.
With Scary Rilla, take my mind. I don't let a memory.
There's great guitar players, but you can say they sound like this guy or they sound like this guy. And you can't say that about him. He doesn't sound like anyone.
Willie, he's just got a sound on the guitar that harkens back to Django Reinhardt. He bends the notes, he plays behind and ahead. He's almost like a jazz guitar player in that way.
No one is saying make concept records in country music, and Willie's making these records that are—they're just masterpieces.
A Willie stranger from Blue Rock Mountain rode into town one day. Under his knees was a raging black stallion. Walking behind was a bay.
When I finally did the Radio Stranger album, it was exactly what I wanted. We did a half, we cut all the tracks the first day, we did the overdub in the second day. The record company thought it was a demo, acting like, well, when you get it finished, bring it back. Out of there came Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain, which was the first record that I got played on the radio.
Twilight, oh, I see her.
Blue Eyes Cried in the Rain, definitely one of my favorite versions of anything ever recorded. The emotion that he gives to that song, the way he delivers it, he owns it completely.
Goodbye,
I remember asking you what you wanted for your birthday. I was like 10 or 11, and you're like, you know what would make me happy is if you learned to play guitar. And you taught me that night, Blue Eyes Crying in the Rain.
In land that knows no parting, blue eyes crying in the rain.
Georgia.
Whatever Willie does, he does it his way.
Georgia. A song
Willie has a sound that if you listen to it 100 years from today, it'd still be good. I mean, Stardust is still around. It ain't going nowhere.
All the songs in the Stardust album and 100 more like it, I've been playing all my life.
Sweet song.
Keep jumping.
Outlaw. It was guys doing their thing. I'm taking it to the people. Willie Nelson, Waylon Jennings. Really, I had everybody from straight folks to hippies and cowboys coming all to listen to the same kind of music.
I got to work on my album with Waylon and John and Chris. It doesn't get any better than that.
Here with Willie Nelson, the man who put it all together.
Little things I should have said.
We're here to get everybody to realize that it's important we save the family farm.
I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind.
How does someone who smokes that much pot get this much done?
I work over 200 days a year out here on the road.
All on the road again. I just can't wait to get off the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get off the road again.
I know from experience that I'd never be happy not playing music. So why try?
I'm gonna do it.
Song justice, so thank you very much. And thank all of y'all for this great honor. I appreciate the acknowledgement of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, included with so many legends and some I'm lucky enough to call friends. It's been a long ride from my first DJ job, from being here with y'all. And as a DJ, I was playing those first songs by Elvis, I remember writers calling that rockabilly rather than rock and roll, and I never did pay much attention to categories, and I'm not sure the fans did either. I did shows with Jerry Lee Lewis and, of course, my buddy Ray Charles, who I've been told were both inducted in the very first Hall of Fame Classic back in 1986. And when Ray and I got together, we never asked each other what to do, or whether to do a soul song or a rock song or a country song. We just sang the songs we loved. And some of my buddies, Leon Russell, Booker T. Jones, two more Hall of Famers, everyone thought we were crazy, and we were, to do Stardust albums of standards, but it turned out pretty good, and folks seemed to like it. Folks also liked the music I made with the Highwayman Brothers. That was fun, with Cash and Waylon and Chris Christopherson. And now that Johnny and I have been inducted, I want to give a plug for Waylon, who played with Buddy Holly, and Chris, who sang so many hits, to be inducted too. And I want to thank my family band for hanging out with me for this ride, and my longtime manager, Mark Rothbaum, for sticking with me through thick and thin, Brian Greenbaum and CAA, and my wife, Annie, for keeping me out here doing what I was put here to do. Thank you, and thanks again for including me tonight, and thanks for appreciating my music. Thank you so much.
Hey, Willie, it is my great honor to induct you into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They gave me this to give you.
Thank you.
Whiskey River, take my mind. Whiskey River, don't run dry. Take my mind.
for thank you. It's a good day. Here we are in